injury news, please, Antonio, if there is any.
Injury news. Bakayoko is out. Luiz is out, and Barclay is out. And then I have a couple of situations that I have to check for tomorrow's game.
Given the schedule you have in the coming weeks, is it fair to say we'll see quite major changes for the whole game tomorrow night? A lot of players who aren't normally involved in the first team maybe get a chance?
Yeah, for sure. We have in front of us 2 weeks very, very tough. And then for this reason, I think it's right to have a program, to have a plan, to face these two tough weeks in the right way. But at the same time, as you know very well, we want to try to go through to the next round in FA Cup competition.
How big a priority is the FA Cup for Chelsea this season? Obviously, you're quite far adrift at the top in the Premier League, but you're still in the Champions League, and the club has quite a rich tradition in this competition.
But I think when you start a season, every competition is a priority, and we tried to do the same in Carabao Cup and to reach the semi-final, and we want to try to fight for every competition, but there is not one priority. There are three priorities in this season, in the rest of this season.
Gary Cahill said yesterday, I think it was, that he came to you last week and discussed the three-day break. Are you pleased you responded and granted that three-day break? And did you notice it in the performance against West Brom, the difference it made?
But I think that it was right. It was right to take this decision. Because in the past we didn't have the possibility to rest, and for this reason I decided in this way. Then, if we won 3-0 against West Brom, I think it doesn't depend on the three days of rest.
You mentioned as well that you're fighting against speculation. That's unusual for most managers. How difficult is that when that speculation is ongoing in the background while you're trying to do your job?
No, but I think about this topic is right to stop. Otherwise, every week we stay to speak about this topic, and we risk until the end of the season not to speak in every press conference. And we must be focused only on the pitch and to try to do our best, me, my staff, and the players, and to try to repeat, to give the best satisfaction to our fans and to try to reach the maximum for this club.
Alvaro Morata looked quite good when he came on for half an hour against West Brom. Is it possible that he's benefited from the arrival of Olivier Giroud and then maybe the competition that brings?
I don't know. I think that Alvaro is a player with a good responsibility, with a good maturity, and I think that the competition is good. It's good for the team, and I think that a great team must have a competition in every position, in every role, and for sure for us. Giroud is a good option. He's very strong, he's a powerful player, and he can help us for the rest of the season.
Can I have your reaction to the retirement of Ryan Mason? You were obviously close to the incident when it happened, and you're playing his club tomorrow night.
For sure, we are very sad for this bad news. And he showed a great great strength to recover, to try to play again, and it's a pity because to stop your career in so young age. Yeah, it's a pity, and this news is a bad news for us, and we are very sad. The players in the club, we wish him and his family the best for the present, the best for the future.
Yes.
We've just seen a couple of nights of Champions League football where Spurs, Man City, Liverpool all getting good results, scoring a lot of goals away from home. Does that prove the Premier League is the strongest in Europe, or is it a change in mentality in how teams now play away from home in the Champions League?
Yeah, I think that in the past, I said different times that this league is very strong, is very tough. I think this is the only league to have six top teams to fight for the title, to fight for a place in Champions League. And the level of this this championship now is very high, and you understand this because in every game there is not easy game. You play against the team and stay in the bottle on the table, and you risk. And in this season, I don't remember that we lost against Crystal Palace when Crystal Palace was at the bottom, and then we lost another game with a team that is fighting for the relegation zone. It means that in every game you have to put 120% of your strength, otherwise you risk. I think in the other leagues there are games that you can manage this game with more facility.
The fans the other night almost immediately started singing your name. They've done it all season. The backing that they are giving you must give you a lot of confidence. You've had a tough time, but the fans have stuck right behind you, haven't they, the whole season?
Yeah, but I think for sure, and I can appreciate a lot this situation, and My task, and the task of my players is to try to put all ourselves for this club, for these colors, for this badge. And I think if the fans, if our fans see this, and for sure they continue to push behind us.
Antonio, is there a situation where we could see Morata and Giroud playing in the same team as a front two?
I think that in the future, yeah, could happen. It could happen if we decide to play with the three midfielders, yeah. But yeah, during the game can happen, yeah. But now I think it's very soon to answer this question. Also, because don't forget that we are playing with a system from last season, and in this case, and it means that Hazard, Pedro, and Willian are out of.
Okay, Nizar.
Antonio, I wanted to ask you about Alvaro. He played, obviously, but he had a back injury, and I wanted to see how his back reacted to playing those like 30 minutes in the game. How's his back now?
No, I think that Alvaro now is having the training with us regularly and in every day, and his physical condition is improving. And tomorrow's game, I think that he will play a part of the game, and he will be ready for the game against Barcelona in Champions League.
Is that a very important part of your plan to use him in these big games that are coming up, because he's a key part of your tactical, the way Chelsea play tactically as well?
Yeah, for sure. in this moment, in every moment, it's very important to have your players, all your players available. Yeah, and in this case, to have two number nine, Morata, and then Giroud, to have two options, is very important for us. Don't forget that for a lot of time, we tried to play with Hazard like number nine, as number nine.
Yeah. Antonio, the schedule in the last couple of months has been relentless, but you had the few days rest last week, you've had Monday to Friday this week. Do you feel that you're approaching the next few games with a freshness in the squad that maybe you've lacked before?
I don't know. I think that we felt the necessity to give a bit of rest, also because during the season we have always played every 3 days, and it was the first week to have 7 days between one game against Watford and the game with West Bromwich, and I think that it was right to give this period of rest. Then I repeat, if you ask me that if we won because we rested, in this case, and I prefer to give 5 days to rest and then to win. 5 days to rest, no training, and then to have this type of situation. But I repeat, I'm joking, and we have to try to continue to play good football, to try to win.
Yeah.